enough about that. Let's talk about my day job. I do have a day job. That's true. I don't just do free comedy shows for a living. Really, stand-up comedy is more like a skill. It's a trade. It's something I'm good at, as evidenced by the last 3 minutes. And I do here and there for a few extra bucks, no big deal. Honestly, customer service is my true passion. And I'm just doing the comedy thing until the customer service thing, like, you know, I can bust out nationally, make myself known in the customer service scene, get my face on the cover of Headset Monthly. A boy can dream. But the job sucks. But I got a raise recently. Yeah, a raise. Woo! Yeah. 7 cents an hour was the amount of the raise. Yeah. Appropriate response. It was, let me break that down in case I flew by anybody too fast. All right, let's start off. 7, moving along. Cents, bring it on home. An hour. That's like $3 a week. I don't even know. I haven't even done the math. Just thinking about it, I'm already in the red. And that's like gross too, before taxes and deductions and FICA. I don't even know what FICA is. Are those people who messed up Hurricane Katrina? Because I don't want to be throwing money at them. They've proven they don't know how to handle it responsibly. But my boss told me about the raise and I was like, wow, I can finally buy that new sandwich I've always wanted. I've had my eye on it for a while, turkey and Swiss. The Swiss is on layaway, but once I get approved for that loan, that is gonna be tasty. Cheese just gets better with age. I like to think it's collecting interest. You should hear me at the fancy dinner parties, swirling around my martini. They're like, what are your investments tied up in? I'm like, Swiss. And they're like, banks. And I'm like, cheese. And they're like, what? So it's one of the many reasons I don't get invited to a lot of fancy dinner parties. It's like reason number 8. Reason number 1, don't like pants. Don't wear them a lot. Thought I'd do you guys a favor tonight. Otherwise, they're going to have to Ed Sullivan this shit on me. They're like, shoot Bill from the waist up. That's actually, they are shooting me from the waist up, but that's in my contract because I have a raging erection right now. I'm just kidding. I'm a pro. I taped this down. The job. I work at a call center. It's like the lowest rung of corporate America, to where they're like, we're only going to pay you $11 an hour, but you still got to wear khakis Monday through Thursday. Oh, I get to wear jeans on Friday. Thanks for the illusion of freedom, jerks. But it's, no, but it sucks. Has anybody here worked in a call center before? All right. 2, 3 of you. All right. This joke's for you. The rest of you take a powder. Well, you know, if you've worked in a call center before, or more than one, it's a very cookie-cutter environment. It's the same wherever you go. The same beige cubicle walls, the same rules, the same stupid headsets and bosses. Like, it's just, like, it's a factory, like, just pumping out crappy jobs. And the first day on the job is exactly the same no matter where you go. I know this because I get fired a lot, so trust me. The first day on the job, it's always the same. What they'll do is they'll take all the new hires and they'll just show them policy videos all day. Like an HR rep will take all the new guys and throw them in a conference room and turn the lights down and the TV on like a teacher with a hangover. And like, if you kids are good, we'll play Heads Up 7-Up. We were and we did. That's beside the point. But the policy videos, it's all stuff like, it tells you stuff that you should know, like just common sense things like, hey, don't be racist and don't grab boobs and don't be racist while grabbing boobs. They really frown upon the double whammy. That's 2 strikes and 1. But the one of the videos they were showing us at this last job I was at, they actually threw me a curveball. It was a safety in the workplace video. And I was like, how unsafe is sitting in front of a computer all day? But I learned the safety in the workplace video, it was just a bunch of cutscenes of people getting messed up in situations that would never happen in an office. And like one of the scenes in the safety in the workplace video, there was a man on a ladder and he fell off like, wah, onto a pile of light bulbs. And it's like, all right, lesson learned. Don't stack your light bulbs up next to your ladders. Yeah. I got some rearranging to do back home. Now I guess I was doing it wrong. But in one of the scenes in the safety in the workplace video, there was a woman mowing a lawn downhill and her foot got caught under the mower. It's just like, argh! Like really graphic, blood everywhere. I was like, I was told this is mostly going to be talking type at the call center, not a lot of landscaping. And they're like, we should have told you, there's going to be a ton of landscaping. And one of the scenes in the safety in the workplace video, this is what a nerd I am. I don't know if you guys are nerds. You kind of look it, I'll admit. But Straight shooter, that's what you're going to get from me. But if you're a nerd like me, you always know it's ever present. Nobody has to tap me on the shoulder and remind me. But there are some moments that like jump out and take me by surprise where I'm like, oh my God, I'm a nerd. And this is what happened. We're watching the Safety in the Workplace video, and one of the scenes, there's a man walking through a warehouse, and all of a sudden the camera cuts to this guy just like pressing a button absentmindedly, click, and it goes back to him. These two machines that go floor to ceiling just start closing in on him really slowly, like, and he's like, hey, I'm in here, like, they're going to crush him. And then I said out loud into a room full of other grown-ups, R2, shut down all trash compactors at detention level. I called out my friends afterwards, both of them, and I was like, no, I think I'm going to be the cool guy in the office. I'm going to be the office Fonz. Like, you know you're the cool guy at work when they start calling you Fonz. You're like, hey, Fonz, the copier's broken, and you're like, hey, thunk, and then starts making copies again. Also, my desk was in the bathroom. I requested that. It's a medical issue. I got the skitter poops. Google it. It's real. Skitter poops. It's hereditary, all right? Back off. Don't judge me. Nobody's Googled it and come to me after a show like, I Googled it. It's not real. One day.